We observed that grapevines that are stressed in some way can produce juice that has a high level of undesirable chemicals that can make the wine taste bad. I'm a flavor and aroma chemist with the Oregon State University Food Science and Technology Department. I'm also a core faculty member with the Oregon Wine Research Institute, based here at OSU. My job is to study aroma and flavor compounds in food, including wine. One of the projects is to investigate the off flavor associated with stressed wine. People describe these off aromas with words like tequila, gasoline, shellfish, peanut, or ashtray. We don't know which stresses to the vines are responsible for these off flavors and aromas. In my research, I'm identifying the chemicals that are responsible for these off flavors. This instrument is a gas chromatograph mass spectrometer. It is our primary tool for the work we do here. We take an example of our bad tasting wine and extract the flavor compounds into a small vial. Then we inject it to the GC instrument. The instrument analyzes the chemical components. Everything happens inside of the instrument, but it will identify about 1,000 chemical components in the wine. It takes about 1 hour. As each chemical is scanned by the GCMS, a little puff of the odor of that chemical comes through this cup, and I can smell whatever it is. These are the chemicals that make up the aroma and the flavor in the wine. Ethyl butyrate, apple, fruity. Ethyl hexanoid, pear and fruity. If the wine has high concentrations of hydrogen sulfide, it will have a sulfur smell, like a rotten eggs. Now we are looking at good flavored wines. We can identify some of the viticulture practices that produce those compounds. We found that when the leaves around the cluster were removed, there were higher concentration of compounds that produce desired aroma, such as beta-damascenol. We found those compounds in the grapes and also in the wine. From many experiments of this kind, we know something about how the physiology of the vine affects the chemistry of grapes. We can trace how the different practices affect the compounds that produce a high quality of wine. We are looking for a pattern in the chemistry, and once we find the pattern, we can look into the viticulture side and hopefully find out what we can do in the vineyard to make those wines better. I'm grateful to the Oregon wine industry for supporting my work and my colleagues' work. Our wine growers and winemakers understand the importance of up-to-date research that helps them to stay competitive and keep Oregon wines on top of the market.